the Homestead Act, to the Southern Homestead Act, to the GI Bill, to every time there was an opportunity for African Americans to capture some of the distribution that's coming from the U.S. government, there were systemic ways in which it was that they were excluded. And you can just kind of cascade through just those three narratives, and then the Fair Housing Act and, you know, the redlining and that dynamic. And if you think about it, that the last generation of Americans, the bulk of their wealth came from real estate. And the bulk of that came from a delevering of that real estate, getting, you know, GI Bill loans or whatever it might be, and then delevering those loans. But if you didn't have access to those lenders, and those lenders did not want to lend to you because of the color or hue of your skin, it inhibited your ability to actually create wealth for your family. And now you get into, you know, my generation, and, you know, if you think about now, you know, the generation of us, quote unquote, 50 plus year old, plus or minus year olds, the bulk of the wealth is no longer in the homes, but it's in the capital markets in the form of stocks, bonds, et cetera. But if you didn't participate in that last cycle, you're not going to really participate in this next one. So the role of CDFIs right now is really to get, in my mind, assets in the form of, in most cases, debt into these businesses and institutions to support these communities and at scale. And so rather than have, quote unquote, half of the lending capacity, well, let me put it this way, you know, African-American businesses typically only get about half of the lending availability than half of the lending amount. So it is systemically subscale in their capacity to leverage, lending institutions to actually grow the businesses. And so our role as CDFIs, as MDIs now, is to say, okay, you know, we need to level this playing field and equalize the opportunity that is America to these communities. And it's not just African-American, it's Latinx, but and rural, but it's the African-American community that has disproportionately suffered based on those four or five things I just mentioned, from, you know, Fair Housing Act to the, you know, Homestead Act, Southern Homestead Act, GI Bill, et cetera. So it's now it is the right time to do this. And there's enough liquidity of assets in the markets today. We just have to get them driven into the places where these businesses exist. Enable these businesses to actually be more productive, which gets back to one of the early points. You know, the world that I live in is enterprise software. Enterprise software is business software. Business software is the most productive tool introduced in our business economy over the last 50 years. You know, the average software product that we sell to our customers gets a 650% ROI. If you implement enterprise software in a small business, one that you might lend to, they get about a 900% ROI, plus it provides transparency to you all as the banks, lending institutions, et cetera. So I think the second part of this, or the third part of this, first part is getting capital into the CDFI, MDI networks. And I'm not talking about, you know, 50 million, I'm talking about 300 billion is sort of the right levels, the way I think about it. The second thing is to modernize the CDFI infrastructure, core banking, processing card payments, you know, mobile, internet, voice, mortgage lending analytics, all those sorts of things. And also enabling you all to partner with some of the large-scale banks who can enable call it fluid liquidity system for you all. And then the third thing is actually modernizing the business infrastructure of the small businesses that you lend to. Payroll, processing, general ledger, scheduling software that can, for the smallest of these companies, is $50 a month, and for the largest, you know, a few thousand a month. But the ROI on those products are hundreds of percent. Which is probably the best next investment any of them would make. And that's how you can grow these businesses. And I think if you put those things together, which we have an opportunity to do now, it creates a levelization of economic opportunity that then stabilizes a lot of the, you know, the communities, stabilizes the call it the hope and optimism of folks saying, you know, I actually can progress in this country, and it's going to be this infrastructure, CDFI, MDI infrastructure, that will likely be the exact conduit to that economic level, equalization. And so that's why it's so critical that we build this infrastructure, strengthen this infrastructure using technology and capital know-how, and assisting the small to medium businesses so that they can also modernize their infrastructure as well.